Hey guys, Nick here today, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Survival on the MapleCraft server. Now, in the last episode, I think I came through here, and I showed this off, that there was a ravine there that we would go exploring, but first I'd just like to show off a bit of progress that I've had. I've been developing these areas. This is the chest room. We'll have chests in there, of course. This is the dining room. Kitchen. No dining room. I forgot to make one. Shoot! Gonna have to, like, redesign or something. Oh, there's also a considerably sized cave over there, which I think links up to the ravine that I saw earlier. This is going to lead to who knows where, somewhere, for sure. Over here is the brewing area, the brewing room, of course. And over there will be a, an entrance to a mine, a mineshaft thing doodle that I designed, and I don't know if I want to build it anymore because, I don't know if I want to mine. So, yeah, that's basically the design. It's kind of a small place. I didn't really realize how small it was until I actually started building it here, and I realized I could just, you know, run around this place so easily. This isn't finished at all. I'm going to add, you know, more stuff and things and whatever. But this is basically the basis. Oh, in here is going to be, it's basically a pen for sheep and stuff and, you know, animals. It's going to be tough getting them down here. I know, but when I do, it'll be cool, and there'll be probably glass here. I was thinking glass, but now that I'm actually looking at it, I kind of like how open it is, so I might just do some fences. Just, you know, something so they can't come through, but so I can see them. Yeah, and then that will be the, you know, to the next area. So, kind of quick, kind of short, but yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. Over this direction, still have not designed what is going there. I have an idea. Over here, I have another idea. Now, this and this, they're both going to take probably a considerable amount of time. This one probably less than this one. And the idea I have for going this direction is the one that takes a lot of TNT. And I think I mentioned that. So, yeah. It's, probably going to be a while before I get to those, so I have to think of some new ideas and such while I wait. Anyway, the point is, we're here, we're mining, it's, you know, stuff gotta do. Mostly just because I found this mineshaft, and, you know, I don't have any new ideas for building or anything. I'm kind of on a dry spell. I think I don't want to do it, but I think I might, you know, take a break from MapleCraft for a week or something. Mostly just because, man, I really don't want to say this, but I may have to be up to a month taking a break, and, you know, maybe I'll get some things done here and there, but certainly not, you know, daily or every other day videos or anything like that. I really like this. This is my favorite. Like, it's the thinnest ravine ever, and it's just, oh, I love it. It's pretty cool. I like this close, you know, small space. The big ravines are cool, sure, but, you know, they're everywhere. This is a rare thing. And, you know, it's so unnatural of a Minecraft ravine to be so thin and small. Anyway, I don't want it to be up to 3 weeks, but in 3 weeks, I'll be out of school for 2 weeks for a winter break thing, and then I'll have plenty of time to record and whatever. However, until then, life and school and stuff is really hectic, and it's gonna be hard keeping up with all the stuff, especially, you know, YouTube and you know, my hobbies and school, that's what it's called, yeah, school, duh. But you know, my hobbies, I mean, as in, you know, pursuing dreams or whatever, you know, lame stuff like that. And along with that, speech and debate is also, you know, I gotta write some speeches and such. I also have community service opportunities and stuff that I gotta do. I have one coming up this Saturday, which is, you know, sort of why I'm saying this now and not after that. And it's a 12-hour event, and I have to be there all 12 hours because, we need 30 total hours, and I am 12 hours short. Well, actually, I'm only 8 hours short, but, I think he's not gonna consider some of my hours because they're all in theater. And I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but, you know, if I have, sorry, but I'm going to re-say it. But I think it's really stupid how he does his system, because he wants you to do community service, which, you know, that in it by itself just ruins the point of community service if you're forced to do it sort of ruins the values and the, you know, the thing that makes it community service. I don't know. The service part of community service. Instead it's community chore, community force. I don't know. I don't know what you'd call it, but it wouldn't be service. It wouldn't be a service to them or yourself if you're forced to do it. Because then you do, you know, a half-assed job and you're not really trying or anything because you're forced to do it. And, you know, people don't like being forced to do things. Oh my god, I hear someone and I know they're right. Yeah. Right here. What level am I at? Okay, so I'm pretty high. Whoa, a giant room here. Hello. Hello! No thank you! No thank you! I'm just gonna... If I'll get this, the thumbnail if it kills me. Okay. So yeah, not only, you know, forced community service, and it's not like I'm against community service or anything like that. Yeah, screw people. Nah. Yeah, whatever. It's just, I don't, like... Oh my god. My family doesn't really do it, so, you know, I'm not really involved in any sort of community service community, you know, any type of that thing, so I don't know when events are going on, or where, or when, or what, so, you know, I'm basically out of the loop for that kind of stuff, so, it's, and with the lack of time and school focus and everything, it's really just not on my, you know, on my list of priorities to help someone else when I need to be helping myself, you know, get through school and you practice stuff, life skills, work on things that are important to me later in my life. So yeah, not only is it that, but he also makes it so that you can't do too many hours in one individual thing, which is really stupid because if you're forced to do community service, well, you're going to want to do it in your favorite thing, but you can't do it all of it in your favorite thing, or it doesn't count. So that's wonderful. Like, I love theater. I don't mind doing, you know, lots of work for theater and stuff because I love doing that behind the scenes, whether it be painting sets or helping with makeup, helping, you know, find and set up props or whatever it might be. You know, there's a lot of stuff. Publicity as well is a thing. Running crew, ushering, you know, house crew, that type of stuff. I love all of that, and I would love, you know, I love doing that in my free time when I have the, you know, the time and whatever. However, now I can't, you know, I can't do that because I have to spend my time doing something I don't want to do instead because I can't do what I want to do because for some reason it doesn't count because I like it. So it's no longer about, you know, the values that it teaches you or whatever. It's about forcing kids to do something that they don't want to do and they can't do it for something that they actually want to do it for. It's about the torture, not about the fun. I don't know. So yeah, I gotta do that, and I probably have to do all 12 hours or else I will not have enough hours. And it's only 30 hours, which, you know, isn't that much, especially considering we got, I don't know, 16 weeks or so to do it, even though he didn't tell us about it until about, you know, 6 weeks in. So yeah. Anyway, the point is, you know, it's not that difficult, but like I said, I'm sort of out of the loop on these things. And not only that, I can't really do it all for theater, so you know, at times when other events are going on, I'm doing theater stuff or speech and debate things, and I'd rather do that stuff, you know, over anything else. So I, you know, it gets down to the wire like this, where I'm at the end and I have to do 12-hour events just to fulfill my requirement. Yeah, again, it's not that much. Next year I have 50 hours, and on top of that, I have, you know, whatever else the teachers will throw at me, which will probably be an extra 50 hours. So I probably have to do like 100 hours of community service, which will be wonderful. And, you know, I'd rather not do it. Luckily, one of the 50 is over the course of the entire semester, so it's really like 75 per semester. So that'll be nice. But the point is, it takes a lot of time, you know, out of the day. Because usually it's in the middle of the day or whatever. It's never in the morning or in the afternoon when it's really convenient. And, you know, you can just go for a few hours and then come back home and enjoy the rest of the day. Or whatever, you know, it's right in the middle of the day, prime time. And then, you know, you whatever stuff. I'm sorry, I'm losing my train of thought. Oh man, I'm using my pickaxe. Well, shoot. I'm using my pickaxe. Oh, really? I didn't know that. I thought I was digging this with an axe. A normal axe. Should have chose a shovel. That would have been a better tool. I was thought I was digging it with a hoe. Yeah, man. Okay, let's just... Bam, torches. Heck yeah! So, yeah. Basically, life is pretty hectic right now with the community service stuff that I need to do, because... I need to set up some other stuff just in case, because pretty much all of my hours now are theater hours for ushering and, you know, working the shows and stuff. So most of them are probably going to get invalidated, which means I have to, you know, get as many extra hours as I can as a safety cushion of sorts. So along with being busy with that, I also have, you know, my... I don't know what to call it. Pursuing my hobbies. I don't know. You know, things that I actually want to do. I also have school and homework. And so, you know, between everything, it's very hard to diamonds. it's very hard to diamonds, yes. No, but diamonds are very hard. They're whoosh, so hard on the hardness scale. I'll just stop talking now. What was I saying? But it's okay. In the time it took me to say that, I remembered! Oh my god! No! No! Okay. Stop! No! 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 Stop it. That's not gonna stop baby at all. Ah, he's walking really slowly towards me. Let's just grab this lapis real quick. Anyway, yeah, trying to balance everything, very difficult, not a whole lot of free time. I genuinely wish I did have more. I love doing this YouTube stuff, and I hope I don't get kicked off the MapleCraft server for inactivity. But, you know, I gotta do what I gotta do, if that means not recording for 3 weeks so that I can record for 2 weeks. Then, you know, that's that. And during those 2 weeks, I will make sure to get as much as I can recorded. Unfortunately, that'll mean that, you know, I'll record an episode and it'll probably come out a month later, which means it'll be irrelevant by that time. And the thing is, I sort of hate seeing episodes like that, because it's all like, why did you have this episode for so long? Why didn't you post it earlier? Like, that development happened forever ago, and you're just now showing it, but everyone else already showed it. I hate not only seeing, but releasing episodes like that. So it's mostly just going to be... in my base and my side of things that I'm going to be focusing on, not really going to spawn. If I do a collab or whatever, I'm going to just, I'm going to push that to the front of the posting list, which means other things might get pushed back. Oh my god, oh my god, why did I just cut, let's just get rid of it completely. Which means other things might be pushed back, so there might be some crazy finagling and an inconsistent schedule, you know, after this lack of posting when I do get back. So sadly things aren't really going to be how they were before until summer break, and then you know, at that point in time it'll probably be, I don't want to say it probably will be, because you know, the 50 hours I need to do next year, one of the 50 hours at least, is, you know, over the course of the entire school year, over the senior year. In fact, I think I can start it now. If I really wanted to. The thing is, though, I need to get it approved, and it needs to be actual community service. This means not, you know, theater stuff, ushering, though it does, you know, help my school or whatever, and, you know, it's ushering. It's not really, you know, value building. It doesn't build actual value to use. All you're doing is holding a door, and, you know, it's a thankless job, sure, but it's, you know, people can hold their own doors open, so it's really not that big of a deal. Not that big of a thing, and I'm not going to be able to do that. That being said, you know, I'm not going to be able to do some of these things, like, before I've done the 12-hour event, I can't remember what it is, but it's a marathon thingy doodle. Okay, wow. let's block myself up before I die. That was quick thinking. Thinking at its quickest. I'm just going to get out of here now before I lose my diamonds. Okay, let's sit for a second and talk. It gives me time to think anyway, which is good. So, yes. Before I've done... I can't remember what it's called. It was at a high school. It was a marathon thingy. It's an all-nighter. I can't remember what it is, but it's an all-night marathon, and I think it's a cancer walk thing, doodle. I'm sorry that I don't remember the name now. Whoops. But I did it before, and it was an easy 12-hour event, and that would not count at all for my 50 hours. So what I was thinking of doing is, over the summer, going down and volunteering at, like, a hospital or some place like that, or, you know, finding a soup kitchen and going in every day for, like, an hour for 50 days. And it'd be really easy, you know, I just go in, go out, get my hours, whatever. It's nice values, I'm helping actual people. You know, there's, you know, actual things happening, not just me doing a job that someone could do by themselves, I guess, like holding a door open. But, you know, actually helping people and stuff like that, stuffle doodles. So, you know, I might be busy during the summer because of that. However, the thing I'm trying to say is it'll be a lot easier during the summer because while I may not have infinite free time, you know, I will have considerably more than I would have during the you know, during the school year. However, that being said, all of that being said, in the free time or whatever, I have to be honest with you. This previous summer, I like wasted pretty much. I think it was partly because, come on, just blow up. No, not on me. I was blocking. Darn. Actually, there's some armor in here. Thank goodness for that. Let's just take that and that. And we'll take some food. Okay, I was saying words, and they were important. Thanks, me. You're so smart. I don't know. Oh, right. I was, you know, because I had such a consistent recording schedule type thing, and, you know, I was already getting a little tired out by the time summer started, and, you know, at that point in time, I was like, I don't want to do anything anymore. Plus, I was taking an online health and PE class, so... You know, I wasn't really as committed or whatever as I could have been to doing YouTube and things. And, you know, it's not like YouTube is extremely important or anything, and I should be committed to it. But it's something that I like to do, and, you know, I definitely could have put a lot more work into it. I think I had, like, one episode a day, which, you know, sounds like a lot, but in reality is nothing. You know, when you have nearly infinite free time, as I did have during that time period, you know, posting every day is just, it's like meaningless because I have so much time that I could do 3 videos a day, maybe 4 with the amount of time I had, and I didn't, and I feel really bad because of that, you know, because I squandered the opportunity. I could have done so much more, but I did not. Which, you know, really is not just a, darn, well, I'll do better next time, but more of a, you know, a lesson to me that sometimes I can be lazy, which, you know, is something I'm watching more closely now. It's something I'm trying to get better with, because, you know, lately, yeah, that was smart, Nick. I have been in sort of the mindset that, you know, I don't have to do it now, so I won't do it now, or I don't have to do it, so I'm not gonna do it, because, you know, there's other stuff to do, and not only that, because it's something I don't want to do, and I've been trying to, you know, it's a slow process. You can't just sort of jump right in and be like, I'll do this. Then you get overworked. And I suppose you could, but overtired, overworked, over whatever, all that stuff. But the point is, you know, I, okay, just trying to be careful about the law here. You know, like math homework. None of my math homework is ever due for the class I'm taking, which means that I don't do it at all because, you know, it's not due. So why do something that I don't have to do when I can spend doing time using the time in other ways, such as playing Minecraft and recording, or, you know, doing other life stuff, like hobbies and whatever. I still don't know what to call it. No! Okay, that was not as close as I thought it was. But you gotta say, that was pretty fast reflexes. Hey, old buddy, old pal. Hey! Don't blow my torch. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make... I was hoping by saying that I would have enough time to remember what I was talking about. Nope, I still don't. I'm bad at memorizing, remembering, and I talk a lot. But the thing is, the good thing about that, and now I'm jumping around, and I'm sorry if I never get back to my other point, because, you know, I don't remember now what I was talking about. But I think you get the point, because I was talking about it for a while. Anyway, jumping away from that, hope you're not, you know, too upset that I didn't finish my thought process. Yeah, that's something I do a lot. Sorry. Hi, I'm Nick. I'm trying to remember. It's gonna kill me. One second.